Woo! Alright, so just to warn you guys beforehand, I am dead on arrival here. This is not comforting at all. That's not good. That's not good. That's not good. Ah, damn it. We're all dead on arrival. Everything's dead on arrival. Son of a bitch. Yes. So. Let's try. You know, we have not tried. Let me just check this one more time. Yep. We have never tried to actively use. Should I use Tager? Should I use Azreal? It's been a while since I've actively used Azreal against other people. So I'll do this. Let me change my parameters here. One and above anyone. Let me just search for. Okay, nothing there. So what did I want to entry? Is this what I want to do, right? Yes. And then I can go elsewhere and do other stuff whilst waiting. So now let's see how this works. Let's see if it works out for me.
Please select your character.
If it gives me anything worthwhile. But anyway, Labor Day weekend. Gotta fucking love it. I don't actually. But you gotta fucking love it. I had a 15-hour day yesterday. I'm looking at about another 12-hour day today. I haven't finished yet. Because the thing about holidays is I need to, like, I start out in the morning and I do my regular shit. But then I gotta go back out in the afternoon to busier stores to, like, rework them. Because, you know, like, they're so busy that their shelves run out of shit. And so I go back in and I refill the shelves. And it is just a pain in the ass. I don't know. What am I doing here? Well, this is a good start. Ah, fuck it. I don't even care. How are you gonna join me? How are you gonna do me like this, bruh? Go fuck yourself, then. Asshole. Oh, that worked. I thought that was too late. Oops. It'd be nice if that worked. This is a testament. What am I doing? This is a testament to just how fucking tired I am. I swear to God I did it right that time. Damn. Go the fuck away, dog. I'm not agreeing to you anymore. You fucked up. Damn. I'm so good at this. Oops. Yeah, that kind of fucks it up, doesn't it? Stupid. I hate people like this. Like, they don't fucking get the hint. And, like, all you're doing, like, it's not gonna make me mad, it's not gonna piss me off, you're not trolling me, all this literally does is just waste both of our time, it just wastes our time. Like, I'm not gonna play this dude anymore, you're a shitty connection in the first place. And then you just sit there like an asshole the first time around and make me wait. Like, no thank you. Whoa, that was fucking, can't believe that worked. But it did. Oops. Ha! Keep forgetting that I should probably reset that first. Yeah, that hits hella awkwardly. How can I make that not hit awkwardly?
Here comes a new challenger.
think I should just give up on that combo. I'll never be good enough. To do double weak point combos. Just won't happen. I just need to come to terms with that right now. I'll never be the best. Of course I'll never be the best Azreal. Doguro exists. You motherfucker. But yeah, apparently Doguro won. Arc Revo. Yeah, this is shit. Mash. Mash. His mashing beat mine. Yeah, I'm gonna block that. Oh, I tried to throw that. The best connection with the best player. I'm gonna start with a 6D because this dude's mashing his invincible moves, but the invincible moves don't work against that bit! Oh shit. Oh, I tried to TP. I was gonna mash B. Damn, this person called me out so hard. Oh no, I'm not gonna mash B anymore. I'm gonna do Astral. That's gonna hit. I love that hitbox. Oh, did this person just rage quit on me? Homie just rage quit on me. Quality. I wasn't even paying attention. I was looking to see where my drink was at. How the flying sh. Damn it! God damn, I suck! This is so weird. Oops. Now it's gonna fuck. What the hell? This is the worst. This is literally the worst. That must have just found me a ranked match, because, like, didn't really? I would have thought that huge ass, like, random lag spike in the middle of this would have been finding me a ranked match. Damn it! Maybe that was it. Another one bar? Whatever. I mean, it doesn't seem like the pickings are exactly the greatest at the moment, so what are you gonna do? That's stupid. They need to just give up with this whole, like, not giving the person of, like, just take a win away from the person that disconnects and give a win to the person that didn't disconnect. Yo, what is with ranked match people and not understanding that, like, especially on a one bar, you don't skip any part of the intro. You let that shit play. Just leave it alone. But I'm gonna do the patented 4-JB. Nice burst. End of the combo when we burst. So we have somebody that totally knows what they're doing right now. Mashing the hell out of buttons up there. Oh, Jesus. We got our one bar connection right at the end of that. Wasn't really feeling anything right until that moment. I have no idea what just happened right there. I have no idea why this shit's missing. Oh fucking hell, I was in the wrong direction. I missed anyway. Nice punish. We just have the best competition right now. This is the height of Blaze Blue? Like, how do we have, like, genuine new people coming out right now? Like, genuinely new, mashing, like, no idea what they're doing people. Really? God damn, I hate that shit. Oh my god, man, why am I like... Yeah, that's how I must be able to hit 5A earlier than that, because that's so awkward. And I've never seen, like, actual people that do that combo. Ooh. I've never actually seen it be that. You know what? Actually, I think one of the main things... No, it's still hella awkward. But that was one of the main things, is that I usually see the people that do that. They don't use 6B, they use 5B, just because 6B is like that little, just a little tiny bit more difficult. Alright, well, you can go ahead and fuck right off then. Oops. People with weird ass hitboxes, I'm telling you. The worst characters in the game. Oops, I don't know what the hell I'm doing.
Here comes a new challenger.
A Tager player. Tager player with a very good win-loss record. Let's see what we gotta look forward to. I haven't seen a Tager in, like, probably since before the English version came out. It's been a long time since I played against a Tager. But this connection is looking truly one bar. Like, the other ones were staticky, but they were generally smooth. This one looks atrocious. I guess I should just give up on everything. Give up on the world until Google Fiber comes my way. Every single one of you should flood Google and tell them, get Nate Aristotta Google Fiber. Don't actually do that, because it'll never... That won't work. Like, who the fuck is this motherfucker spamming our Oh god, this is terrible. This is really, just truly terrible. Bitch. This is really, just truly the worst. Like, I hope this dude just rage quit. If this dude didn't rage quit, I'm a rage quit. Like, nobody deserves to be put through this shit. It will be faster to reset this game and go back in than it would be to actually finish that match. I guarantee fucking see it. Watch me have a red name now. I'm a rage quitter. It does depend on how many, I mean, I guess it would matter on which matches they decide from, but if it's like a percentage base of my ranked matches, I honestly might get a red name. Because if it's like 10%, well, I mean, that's one rage quit out of, what, like, 16, wow, how many, what? No, actually, I'm thinking of that differently. I was thinking, like, there's 8 and 6 on there, so obviously I've played, like, 14 matches, but no, that was, I haven't even played 10 matches with Azrael. I think I played all of, like, 5 or 6 with Tager. So, yeah, if it's a 10%, like, verification rate on there, I might have a red name now. Oh, no. If I got a red name, I'm done forever. I'm gonna have to do this with, like, every single video. Give myself an ultimatum. I'm just quitting the game forever, because, like, this is... I can't even complain anymore. It's my fault. I'm putting myself through it. It's gonna fucking happen. But, yeah, that shit... I mean, honestly, if I could just... Isn't that the person that rage quit on me? I feel like that person was the one that rage quit on me. See, is this... So we have at least two European rooms for sure. And there's a Chile room in there. At least I would assume that's since they're going to put Chile. And this is just... This is... Oh, wait. There was a two bar. I mean, I don't really trust it. Because, like, if it says two bars, okay. Isn't that person kind of well known? It's Bulbasaur? But yeah, I don't really trust it, because, like, one of the main things I actually use to tell, like, in Street Fighter is how fast the connection actually comes up, like, how fast it tells you this is how fast the connection is, because that's how long it took to connect to that connection. And so, and, like, in that one, it didn't actually say that there was that it was two bars for ages. But hey, I mean, this is the best chance we got. I honestly can't, like, at this point, I'm not even excited for Persona 4 Arena because it's Persona 4 Arena. I'm excited for it because there will be people playing it. Whereas Blaze Blues, it's dead now. There aren't people playing it anymore. It's kind of one of those things where it's like, yes, you can find a match. Yes, it's not, you know, like, you're not sitting around for 20 minutes to find a match. Obviously, I found plenty right there. But you're still, it's still that,
Please select your captain.
You're not finding ideal matches.
I am Tager.
You're not finding stuff that you, like, you know, okay, this is perfect. You're not finding plenty of those. Whereas, you know, in a game like Street Fighter, where there's always a huge population of people playing it, you can always find an ideal match whenever you want to. There's no... It's always easy. Alright. Clap my hands together. And I'm praying to the gods of online right now. I'm gonna bow my head in respect. And this motherfucker didn't even do... I'm gonna guess 3C. My 5A really didn't even hit that? Like, are you real? I tried, I don't know why I bothered trying to 360 see that. That was dumb. I don't know why I bothered, but yeah, this dude is just hitting buttons and jumping. Ooh, high lag. Nice backdash. It's getting, yeah, now it's getting laggy. I deserve that. I don't know why I tried to wake up 2C, like that's a good fucking move. That was, okay, yeah, sure. I don't know why, like, why am I trying to 2C this dude? Why am I trying to 2C this dude? I've gotten blown up for it every time. Like, I'm calling him out 100% correctly. I'm calling him out perfectly every time. But I'm calling him out with a character that doesn't get to call people out on wake up. You don't get to do that. It's silly of me to... Like, this is already a bad matchup in the first place, and I am playing it as terribly as a person can play it. Because, like, I'm just... I keep, you know, like, in an ideal world, this would work. This should work if this character actually functioned as a proper character. But he doesn't, and he never will. So it's stupid of me to continually expect, like...
Do not hold
I know this is exactly what he's going to do, but... I just have to accept the fact that there is absolutely nothing I can actively do about it. This dude is just the best. He's literally just throwing out buttons and there's nothing I can actually do about it. Don't fuck that one up. Thanks, magnetism. That was amazing. See, like, this dude just, he got a hit. And then he immediately hits throw. He has no idea what he's doing. It's just that bad of a matchup. This dude has no idea what he's doing. Literally no idea what he's doing, and I'm just letting him blow me up because I'm playing like a fucking moron. Because I'm playing like a tired idiot. Yeah, stupid of me to try to fuck with 3C. But do you see what I mean here? Like, do you really see what I mean? This dude doesn't have shit. He doesn't even have combos. He's literally just doing stuff. Counter that, asshole. Nate's mad. Losing a bad matchup to a player that shouldn't be beating me. Okay, thanks for the Atomic Collider. I'm the best. That was dumb. Nice combo, dude. Yes, of course I didn't detect that. Oops. It was supposed to be 3C, obviously. Like, I'm calling him out correctly at I'm calling out what he's going to do perfectly every time, but I am picking the worst way to actually beat it. Every time. It's so terrible. Like, every single time I hit a button, I'm just sitting here thinking, like, what are you doing? It's not gonna fucking work. I knew he was gonna jump there, but what the fuck is JA gonna do against somebody that's jumping? It's just gonna put them in block stun. It's not air unblockable. It's not unblockable. They're just gonna block it, and they're gonna continue on with their life. Not being hit by Tager because you're picking the wrong moves to use, dumbass. I love my brain sometimes. With punish, gotta love it. Tager's backdash nerf, gotta love it. Fucking really? Really? God, I hate this game sometimes. Doing that every single time, like I'm gonna be able to late tech and blow it up. He's holding up, I'm gonna be able to blow it up every single time. All I gotta do is stop getting hit by this dude's stupid mashing and I'll be good. But that's a tall order for Tager against Hakumen. I tried to 360A that. Yo, there's lag right now, though? Damn it. I love that move so much. Come on. I'm gonna blow him up with this. Darn, I didn't. I didn't get over that for realsies? Come on, Tager, you gigantic fat ass. Thought for sure I'd get over that. 360X. Why am I trying to you cannot anti-air this character. Nate, stop trying to anti-air this character with your character. You can't fucking do it. Jesus. Huh? Anybody want to explain to me how armor didn't catch that? Cause there was more than enough time for armor to catch that. There was so much time. That's really confusing. Like, how did armor not catch that? Armor should have caught that. Weren't you the person that rage quit on me? I swear to God. Oh, we're not waiting that long. Not for this dude. This dude is not worth waiting for that long. But now we are gonna have to sit here. But I am gonna check this out. I gotta find this out because I believe I can watch videos that are still being recorded. Nope, can't. It's not done yet, so I can't watch it. But I swear, like, wasn't that the person that rage quit on me? I'm not gonna play somebody that rage quit on me. You can go fuck yourself. If you're not, I'm sorry, but either way, we're too late into this video to do a set in the first place. Yeah, I'll freely admit, there's a little bit of salt right now. I mean, I kept picking the wrong shit to do. Pure and simple. I made the right read with the wrong move literally every time. Even then, the majority of the time, the right read with Tager, you can't actually do anything about it anyway. Like, it's completely irrelevant that you made the correct read. A lot of the times, Tager as a character just doesn't have the tools necessary to actually act on your reads. That's just how it fucking is. How do you fucking do this again? That's how you do it. Is he here? Because I'll try a 2-bar connection. If this motherfucker here. But that motherfucker ain't here. I hate this game. I mean, I'll freely admit, when it comes to games like this, a lot of the times, it's really just my, it's literally just my own personal impatience. Let me up this to 2. Why did that, oh, that's right, because I did quit the game. I did rage quit, so that did happen. Wish I could play that dude. It's too bad there's no information on the, what does it say? 16 matches and 11 victory? Oh, that's right, that's with Tager added on there. Yo! Fuck my life! Fuck my life! Ugh! I hate everything. I hate everything. I think I'm just done. I succeeded in waking myself up through... Go fuck yourself, BlazBlue. I succeeded in waking myself up through maximum saltiness. We got a rage quit. I rage quit. I don't know if that really counted, but I mean, you know, I did quit. I didn't let the match play out. It was better for everybody that I didn't let the match play out, but still. I think we have a successful compilation of all fighting game related things that can occur. Especially including dumbass motherfuckers like K-Kren. I take everything back that I said. You're a wonderful person that accepts matches in an almost timely manner, but not... Oh, goddamn. Oh, goddamn. That's a lot of matches to only have that many victories. That's a lot, especially with Hakumen. Like, I'm sorry, but all you need... Oh, this is why the person loses all the fucking time. It's karma. They don't accept matches in a timely manner. And they skip everything. I'm gonna just run a train on this motherfucker. Oh shit. I did not confirm that properly. Oh god, fuck that up. Rebel 2. Why did I do that? Yeah, it has same attack combo. I'm kind of dumb. Unblockable? Is that air unblockable? That don't make no damn sense. Ah, shit. Counter mashing Hakumens. That's all you gotta do. I mean, granted, Azrael has a really good way of handling that too, because Hakumen can't do shit about meaty overheads. Especially one like 5D, where like 5D is, you can't really, as long as you space it correctly, you can't roll past Azrael, but 5D's hitbox will still reach. I mean, this is only in the corner, obviously. You could, in mid screen, you could back roll a meaty 5D, no problem. But if I space it correctly with Azrael, I can throw out a 5D and it'll catch your neutral wake up. The only thing it won't catch is a delayed wake up, like you can delay in the middle of the 5D hitbox. But then I still have pressure because there's no real recovery at the end of a whiffed 5D. I'll still have the advantage and I can press like 5A or 2A or something to continue my pressure. That's actually what one thing that Dogura does a lot. He'll throw out, like after a JD ender, he'll throw out 2D upon landing, and if they try to late tech, if they try to late tech, they'll get hit by the 2D, and then usually at that point in time, they'll have tried to late tech, and they'll end up neutral teching themselves back, you know, right where they are because of the 2D hit, or they'll tech immediately, and the 2D whiffs, but because of the amount of time it takes for them to tech, he'll still have advantage right at the end of it, but you don't have enough advantage to, like, throw out another mix-up. You just have to start running pressure at that point with, like I said, 5A or 2A, and that's definitely something that I should get used to doing, because the only real thing I do that's even moderately comparable to that is throwing out 6D after a mid-screen, or not 6D, 3D after a mid-screen Recachain. Because, and the only time that, I mean, sometimes it actually works, obviously you've seen it if you've watched any amount of my videos. Occasionally if they're high enough up in the air, then they'll just get hit by it when falling. Some characters just don't get hit by it no matter what. But, like if they're grounded, like if I just do 5 BB into Tiger, Cobra, Leopard, then 6D after that, 6D ends up becoming a meaty where it'll catch a back or a forward roll at the beginning of it. It'll catch a late tech, and if you tech immediately, I can still press buttons and start running pressure afterwards. I don't have as much time as if I did something like that's 3D mid screen has basically been replaced now with dash Sentinel dump. But anyway, that is that. I got my revenge on Hakumen. No, I didn't. That one didn't count. I mean, I'm pretty sure this is one of those like what if scenarios where it's like I'm pretty sure I could have blown that dude up with Azrael, but I didn't want to because it wouldn't prove anything. Like, it's Azrael. Azrael doesn't have a shitty matchup against Hakumen like Tager does. I want to beat him with Tager. I want to show that I can beat him with Tager. And I could have if I hadn't made the wrong choice with every button press I made in the entirety of the match. But hey, like I said, I'm much more awake now. There's nothing that wakes you up faster and better than pure salt. And now I'm awake because of it. Because like I said, I was getting mad. Fucking, it's those situations where it's like, you're either mad at the matchup, you're mad at the other player. Like, this player should not be beating me, but they are, god damn it. Or you're just mad at yourself, and that's what mine was. Like, mine's all salt at myself. It's like, I guess it's kind of a mixture of the two, where it's like, I know I shouldn't have been losing to that person if I had been making the correct choices based off of the correct reads I was making, then I would not have been blown up. But I was making the incorrect choices off of every single correct read that I made. Like, I need to stop acting like 2C is a good move. 2C is a decent move in the way that I used it on his wake up, on people that are just holding up, because there's really no other better option. That's incorrect. You can call them out with an air throw, and even then, air throw is actually probably safer to throw out in general and easy to confirm, because you can whiff an air throw and do like a landing 5B, or not 5B, a landing like a JB on the way back down to continue pressure, and in general, throw recovery is not long enough for somebody to really do anything about that. So there's definitely smarter things that I can do, but the most rewarding thing that I could do is getting that counter hit 2C. It just depends, and I dropped a lot of combos. I didn't confirm a lot of combos correctly. It's just, I mean, that's what happens when you're somebody that doesn't play anything even approaching. You know what? I actually want to. So we have 17 matches. So we can bump that up to 18 to just to, oh, I guess I can. I was actually going to go to my, I guess decode edit. That's not what I wanted. How can I just, like, look at my shit? How can I just look at my own decode shit? Would it just be rankings, I guess? Like, could I just... How the hell has somebody managed to find 12,000 mag? They must be Japanese. See, our own rank is start. Details. There we go. That's what I wanted to look at. Yeah, I don't even have a grand total of 1,000 matches yet in this game. I mean, obviously, I'm close. That is what? That's 873 right there. So, we're at 890. 891. We gotta include our rage quits. So, we're close, but still not to even have 1,000 matches when we've had this game for almost a year. Did this game come out? It came out in September for Japan, right? Maybe it was October. But either way, we've had this game almost a year. And I don't even have, like, an average of 3 matches a day. I should have grinded so much harder back when the Japanese import had come out. Because and right around when the American version came out. Because there were so many more players at the time. And, like, now I should have more matches than this. That's really sad that I don't even have 1,000 matches in this total game. Man. Really, my best score is with Azriel? I would have thought my best score would be with Tsurumi. Wait a minute! What is that? Oh, that's right, because I always did Unlimited Mars in offline, so people didn't... I was avoiding everybody. I didn't want to be like, no, I can't play. I'm playing Unlimited Mars. So I always played that offline, so I never uploaded the time. Damn. So now there's no proof. Now there's no proof that I beat Unlimited Mars. Now everybody's going to think I bought Unlimited Tager. Can you even do that? Can you even buy, like, individual characters? Can we just, like, see it right now? No, I don't care enough about that. I don't want to go all the way to it. If we could just see it from there, then I'd totally check it out. But I'm assuming you have to buy all the characters. Like, you can just unpackage all the characters at once for however much money. You wouldn't be able to buy individual unlimited characters. So anyway, that is that. At least I got some matches this time. And I will try and do my best. Because, I mean, honestly, once Persona 4 Arena comes out, I will be trying to grind. Because I really do want to learn. I really want to learn Ken. And I really want to try and be like... Nah, that's really incorrect. I was going to say, I really try and want to be like a premier American Ken or some shit like that. But I will never get that way without going to offline tournaments. Because I've said this before. I never really make improvements. Like, I make very slow, pondering, wading through molasses improvements when I play, like, by myself or online. I don't really improve that much. But then when I go to an offline scene, an offline gathering, and I play a bunch there, for whatever reason, because of just, I don't know if it's the atmosphere or if it's because there's just a higher level of competition in general, I make exponential leaps and bounds forward in terms of the quality of my gameplay when I go to those. Like, that's how I learned Azriel. I think my Azriel would be terrible without having gone to those and played against, like, really good players. And even now, my Azriel's still not great. It's nowhere near approaching, like, a high level that I would need to actually succeed. I could actually probably succeed in the American scene, because let's be honest, the American scene ain't the best. And by succeed, I don't mean, like, you know, go out and win tournaments, but I could definitely beat the majority of the people out there. But then, you know, like, if I went... If instead of SG and Lord Knight, if I had gone to Japan instead, I would have, like, got perfected the first round, and I would have been like, alright, this is hopeless. Like, you can just... Here, just have my stick, take my soul, just pretend we're playing Mortal Kombat real quick, just kill me, finish me, please. This was embarrassing. I would get embarrassed at that height of competition, whereas... I feel, you know, in the American tournament scene, I'm pretty sure I could get, like, top three pretty consistently at locals. Versus, you know, like, if you gathered all of the, like, best players from those locals, I wouldn't stand a chance at getting anywhere. But it's just really telling that, like, the last CS2 tournaments that I went to, there was a minor tournament that was put together by a guy for charity in the Davis area. And I made top 8 in that tournament, and I honestly should have made top 4, but I choked terribly. Like, I played terribly, and I lost to a dude that counterpicked me with Hazuma. Started out with Jin, and I blew him up, and then he picked Hazuma, and I just kind of, like, laughed at it. And I think that kind of, like, killed me. Like, it took me out of, like, everything, because I just kind of laughed. Like, are you really doing that to me? Like, I don't even play this game, and you got to counterpick me with Hazuma? Really? But I still made top 8 there at pretty good competition. I made top 3 at another local gathering back when, like, this was back when I didn't even play. And it's just that kind of thing where, like, I'm not trying to shit on people and, like, lift myself up on my own quality. I just honestly don't really believe in the level of competition that's in America at the moment. I don't think that people care. It's not, I mean, it's nothing, like, I'm not shitting on the players, like, all the players suck. I just don't feel like there's enough people that care enough to get up to that next level, to the point where they are, like, truly competitive at the game. So anyway, that was, why do I always gotta end every single one of these videos with, like, 12 minutes of rambling now? It's ridiculous. I gotta stop that. I gotta cut that out. Gameplay or nothing. But yeah, I mean, I wish that I had the time and the means to still go to tournaments, because I really did enjoy my time at tournaments. But it's just, now I gotta get my life moving forward. I gotta make that paper, and we don't get that elsewhere. Well, anyway, thank you for watching. Peace out. I really want Persona 4 Arena to be out already.